Okay, cho. Ong chung rep ka mto ka chamna ka na te si samna ka hai mun nang prab dikha chun te krom pha prinyat dam bai mto ka tang samruai ne dal jipu sa sai ong chung rep mien bamnong sdap ne sarana ptoal mot robos pheki pya pon nang samna som robos tha mitvi ka pi kdai nun chi som prab pra aikasa dai ong chung rep mun nang sdap takhai kam sa sai pttw 88 aikasa E. By Ribble Slapram, Church P, Church Bombay. I the Knongside I guess E. Bayroy Pull, Slapram, Church P. Church Bombay, Ekrom, Major B. Capic, Nun here, Mantana Sombra Prano, Trekband, Bob Price, Chippewa, Angli, High. I capim Sermain, Montreal, Babjon, Pooh, about Angibra, the Bong, Mantun, the Nunta Piki, Tang Angibra, Minimum Long Sadapner, Sarana, Tol, Mot about Piki, a Pet Pon, Lip Hip, I just do your band, I guess, a Kang Lu, Montopica, Chop Sombra, a wet team, Moyne, Tamna Cabrini. I try any. I just bong on your breath of the car to the Gromta Prenya by Minoka to car, try top the nuns of now some of the Bakrom, me to be Capricade Nunji, Aikasani, some June.
Mr. President, thank you. Respectfully. We believe it's much easier for us to respond if we hear what it is that Nguyen Chia believes is relevant to the testimony of the expert who's testifying on the treatment of the Cham from these documents. Frankly, we don't see it at this point, but perhaps he can explain it, and we would see it.
ក៏ដើម្បីច្បាស់លាស់ព្រោះបញ្ហានេះវាយូរហើយហើយដើម្បីមានភាពច្បាស់លាស់អញ្ញាដល់វិការជូនទៅក្រុមសហមិត្តវិការពីក្តីនួនជាដើម្បីឡើងបង្ហាញនៅសំណើសុំរបស់ខ្លួននិងភាពចាំបាច់នឹងមូលដ្ឋានសំត្របតាមផ្លូវច្បាប់ដែលនៃសំណើរបស់ខ្លួនដើម្បីភាគីដទៃទៀតអាចយល់បានហើយនឹងមានមតិយោបល់លើបញ្ហាសំណើរបស់លោកសូមជឿញ
Thank you, Mr. President. I'm certainly happy to do that. What we are talking about, Mr. President, is a set of originally German documents that were drafted and made up by the East German Security Service, in German called the Stasi, S-T-A-S-I. At one point in time, we received from an expert in this area copies of these East German documents. The main part of these East German documents consists of so-called Kurzbiografie, K-U-R-Z-B-I-O-G-R-P-H-I-E, translated into English into short biographies. What happened at the time, as we can distill from these documents, is that a certain number of Khmer Rouge cadres, Vietnam, presumably the Vietnamese intelligence service in 77, 78, possibly 79.
Made short biographies of people who
making up the National Salvation Front.
These are Vietnamese biographies,
and then presumably at one point in time given to their East German counterparts,
and they translated these original Vietnamese language documents.
We received a set of those short biographies. I shall list the nine names of people that we, at this point in time, seem to be the most important and relevant.
We have
short biographies of, respectively, Heng
Samrin,
Hun Sen,
Chia Sim,
Pen Sovan, Hor Nam Hong, Kiu Chanda,
Kai Chanda,
Pen Navut, Uk Bun Chun, and Mat Li.
Nang Mat Li.
And as I said, there are others as well, but let me concentrate on those nine people first. In those biographies, you can see what those respective people have done since they joined
the
revolution, and what they have done to resist the CPK at one point in time. We believe that the background of these nine other people are relevant and are important in the ascertainment of the truth, more specifically, to get a clearer picture of which of the former CPK cadres
were screened by
the Vietnamese and what their possible roles were in resisting the CPK, of which, of course, they themselves were all high-ranking members. More specifically, when it comes to the expert,
we would concentrate on possibly
putting questions in relation to these biographies of only three or four people, possibly five, those who we believe played an important role
As
I indicated yesterday in parts of my questioning, we believe Heng Samrin has an important role as a military commander and a deputy commander in the East Zone. Also in 1975, same goes to Prime Minister Hun Sen, of course, Deputy Secretary of Sector 21, and is also an important person in relation to the events relating to the Cham. The same goes for Mat Li, whose name is redacted, but from his biografy is drafted and made up, we presume that is in fact Mat Li. Other persons that I just mentioned, like Kiu Chanda, who was the president of the Pol Pot Ing Sari Tribunal. The biographies of these biographies are important because they all relate to high-ranking CPK cadres who subsequently defected to Vietnam. for instance, in this, in one of those documents relating to Prime Minister
Hun Sen, one can read that he defected in Vietnam in June 1977.
It also says something about proper revolutionary spirit of of these people.
I have a question which admittedly goes at least partly to probative value, but not only. I note you said the descriptions are important, so I suppose you consider them reliable, or want the chamber to consider them reliable. Now, the first issue you yourself mentioned, this has gone through a translation in this. I mean, into German. It has already gone through a translation from Vietnamese. So we don't have two regionals, that's my understanding, yes. That's just an observation. But the second is more, I agree, it's interesting when it comes to the internal workings of intelligence agencies. But when it comes to the information contained within, do you have any information on what was the basis for these short biographies, which quite often include assessments obviously made by the person who made it? As far as you know, is the basis only an interview with this person, or what other information, if any, came in? Can you enlighten the chamber on that?
That would mean that we have to do further investigation. However, the Chief of the Defense Office was only willing to give us a very, very limited amount of money in order to do this investigation. So this is based on the resources what we got out. It doesn't mean that your question cannot be answered, but we simply lacked the resources to go further. I'm actually quite convinced that there should be additional very interesting material. But because of our limited resources, we have only come up with these short biographies of the key players in the rebellion who apparently, who obviously were alive in 79 when most of them formed There are certain individuals that we do not know who they are. We just got them sometimes out of the description. But possibly be an interesting person. For instance, what we can say with 95% certainty is that one biography which is redacted, that must be Matley, because it, the personal information is very similar as to what we know from his interviews. But there are also certain names which we are not certain of who they are, but we omitted them because they might play an important, more important role when we arrive at the segment of the internal conflict within DK.
Oui, juste une clarification. Vous demandez à ce que ces documents soient recevables.
លោកកောင်សុំឲ្យឯកសារនឹងត្រូវបានទទួលយកដោយអង្គជំនុំជម្រះដើម្បីយកមកសួរអ្នកជំនាញហ៊ីនតុនឬក៏លោកសុំឲ្យឯកសារនឹងត្រូវបានប្រកាសទទួលយកជាលក្ខណៈទូទៅព្រោះថាឯកសារនឹងពាក់ព័ន្ធទៅនឹងវិសាលភាពនៃសំណុំរឿងស៊ូន2លើស៊ូន2ខ្ញុំវង្វេងឲ្យសុំលោកបំភ្លឺឲ្យច្បាស់អំពីចំណុចនេះ
The request is obviously to have them admitted into evidence because we find the documents very relevant as to the statement of the truth, particularly in relation to the rebellion and the armed conflict within Vietnam. Concrete reasons to speak about them now is the issue that we would like to present a few of them to the expert because they are relating to people who are actually high-ranking cadres in Sector 21 and in the East Zone, in which at the time most of the Cham lived. So we would like to put them before the expert. So not all of them, but just a few. But the request is to have them admitted into evidence. And that request relates to all those brought by
the expert.
Oui, merci, Monsieur le Président. Je pense que ce sera peut-être utile que je fasse une observation maintenant que les parties puissent répondre peut-être à l'ensemble des observations de la Défense. Simplement pour indiquer que nous ne nous opposons pas à la demande de nos confrères de l'équipe de Nunchia. Deux observations par rapport aux questions qui ont été posées par les juges ce matin. Un certain nombre de documents ont été acceptés en preuve par la Chambre en lui indiquant qu'elle évaluerait plus tard la valeur courante, ce qui est important dans le cadre de ce type de document. Et ça me rappelle également un autre document que nous avons demandé à verser en preuve et que la Chambre a accepté, qui est le document 3-9644. Qui était un extrait d'un ouvrage russe reprenant les archives vietnamiennes de l'époque. Évidemment, nous sommes dans le cadre un moment d'un conflit armé. Nous sommes dans une période de guerre froide et nous savons que les documents qui émanent d'un camp ou d'un autre peuvent avoir une connotation et peuvent avoir effectivement des interprétations qui sont propres au camp dont ils sont issus. Mais en tout état de cause, pour ce qui est de l'utilisation que va en faire la Défense ou même la Chambre dans le cadre de son délibéré, c'est effectivement pour avoir des éléments de contexte qui sont importants pour savoir, c'est intéressant de savoir ce qui était dans la tête ou ce qui était considéré par le camp vietnamien à l'époque ou le camp allemand à l'époque parce que c'est dans le contexte de la guerre froide, ce sont des éléments d'appréciation qui sont utiles dans le cadre des discussions que nous avons sur un mouvement politique qui est le PCK, dont la Défense a déjà dit à plusieurs reprises qu'il ne s'agissait pas d'un mouvement monolithique et d'avoir effectivement des appréciations que l'on les estime véridiques ou pas, de savoir que c'était les appréciations de l'époque, c'est utile dans le cadre des débats que nous avons devant cette chambre pour une vision. Global de ce que peut être le mouvement PCK à un moment donné et comment il est perçu par les alliés ou par des gens qui ne sont typiquement pas des alliés, qui regardent quelles sont les personnes qui, au sein du mouvement du PCK, peuvent être considérées comme des alliés dans le cadre d'un conflit armé ou d'un conflit politique. Donc, c'était les observations que je voulais apporter en rappelant que ce n'est pas simplement une question de valeur probante en ce sens qu'on estime que c'est la véracité des informations qui figurent dans les documents qui sont utiles, mais simplement de savoir que c'était la vision qu'avait un mouvement politique ou un pays à un moment donné. Voilà les observations que je voulais faire. Merci. 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 Merci.
បាទអរគុណជាបន្តផ្ដល់ព្រឹត្តិការណ៍ជូនទៅសហប្រញ្ញាដើម្បីធ្វើឋានៈតបទៅនឹងសំណើសុំរបស់
Thank you, Your Honors. Your Honors, I think it's important to distinguish two questions before the bench today. And the one is, do the documents get admitted? Are they relevant to the issues in the trial or the defense theory? And secondly, are they relevant to the expert witness who's here to testify or is testifying solely on the treatment of the champ? And frankly, I haven't heard anything in the defense submissions that would show relevance to the treatment of the champ. Counsel has mentioned one biography of a redacted name that he believes is the name of the champ. He hasn't said how that's relevant, but I would say I probably would not. We don't object if he wants to put that particular biography to the expert witness. But asking an expert who's here to talk about the CHAM about the East Zone resistance and the politics of the East Zone, that's outside of his expertise. Distract from the issues that the witness is here to testify about the treatment of the champ. Now, on the admission of these biographies overall, I would say I understand the defense submissions. They think that somehow relevant and probative for their theory of the CPK being always internally in factions, I would say that would be relevant. We think it actually proves the opposite, but we see the relevance. We think it proves that, in fact, there wasn't resistance until the purges were in full swing very late in the regime. And again, even if the information is not correct, it may have some probative value. I agree with you, sometimes submissions on that. For example, we know from, I think, the East Germans and the Soviet intelligence, this is in Stephen Morris's book, that the Vietnamese believe that Nguyen Chia was their man within the CPK. So we do object to use of all of these except for the biography of the CHAM with the expert witness. We don't object to their admission for general purposes. Thank you, Your Honors. Thank you, Your Honors.
Vous allez me dire si j'ai bien compris ce que vous venez de juste nous dire. L'utilisation de ces documents, la grande partie de ces documents pour l'interrogatoire d'experts, mais vous n'avez pas d'objection quant à la recevabilité de ces documents au regard de leur pertinence pour la thèse de défense concernant l'ensemble du procès de
l'UPC.
That's correct. Of course, I don't believe in the defense interpretation, but I certainly see that they have an argument of relevance. So exactly as Your Honor stated, we don't object to the admission of all of these documents on the case. However, the defense, or none of us, should go beyond the expertise of the witness. That's wasting time if we have a witness to testify on expertise of the treatment of the CHAM when they're being asked in general about the resistance in the East Zone. I think that would be irrelevant. Irrelevant, I should say, beyond the expertise of the witness.
Merci le Président, Monsieur le Président, et bonjour à tous. Nous en rapportons à l'appréciation de la Chambre sur ce point.
ដ៏ប្រកាសជូនទៅក្រុមថាមិទ្វីការពីក្តីលោកគឺសំផនអាចលោកនួនជាដើម្បីធ្វើការសារណាតបចុងក្រោយរបស់ខ្លួនទៅនឹង សារណារបស់ភាគីផ្សេងទៀតជាពិសេសសហប្រញ្ញារួមទាំងសហវិនិយោគតំណាងដើមនិងរដ្ឋប្រពៃណីបើសិនមានសូមជឿញ
Yes, Mr. President, thank you. Allow me to respond as to the relevance for the upcoming expert.
Ubunchun
was deputy chief in Sector 21. Sector 21 consists of Khmer district,
which
towns like Kopal, Svetlang, etc. are situated.
In
this Vietnamese biography, we can read that on the 1st of July, 1975, in German, he became Zweiter Sekretär des Gebietes 21. That means he became Deputy Secretary of Sector 21. More interestingly, he says that on the 25th of May, according to his biography, he, and I quote in German again,
verließ die
reaktionäre Organisation. Meaning he left the reactionary organization, meaning the CPK, already in, on the 25th of May, 1975. He is saying in German,
Ich fürchte
den Kampf gegen die reaktionäre Pol Pot in Sari im Gebiet 21. This means in English, I conducted the battle against the reactionary Pol Pot in Sari in Sector 21. Did he do that as of May 1975? How does that relate to him leaving his position only in May 1978? So the authority structure widely discussed by the expert in relation to Sector 21. Should be able to present to the expert because he, as you know, has been questioned on authority structure within Sector 21.
Excusez-moi, oui, je disais non, mais ça me permet de simplement rappeler ce que vous aviez décidé sur le document que j'évoquais tout à l'heure dans votre décision E347-1.56. Et vous avez expliqué que le document que nous présentions a été à première vue pertinent car il traitait notamment du conflit armé entre le Cambodge et le Vietnam ainsi que du contexte historique. Nous soutenons que la même chose s'applique au document proposé par l'équipe de
mission. Merci. ភិក្ខុទាំងអស់ដែលបានធ្វើសារណាផ្ទាល់មាត់ដែលជាមូលដ្ឋានសម្រាប់អង្គជំរះយកទៅពិចារណាសម្រេចឬសំណើសុំរបស់លោកនួនជានឹងបានចេញនៅស្ដីសម្រេចក្នុងពេលឆាប់ឆាប់ខាងមុខនេះឲ្យបានមុនពេលអង្គជំរះធ្វើសកម្មភាពស្ដាប់ទៅខីកម្មអ្នកជំនាញដែលមានហត្ថលេខា PTT W ពីសំណាក់ក្រុមប្រឹក្សាអន្តរជាតិនៅក្នុងប្រទេសកម្ពុជាដែលមានលោកសុនសេនជាប្រធានសំណាក់ក្រុមប្រឹក្សាអន្តរជាតិនៅក្នុងប្រទេសកម្ពុជាដែលមានលោកសុនសេនជាប្រធានសំណាក់ក្រុមប្រឹក្សាអន្តរជាតិនៅក្នុងប្រទេសកម្ពុជាដែលមានលោកសុនសេនជាប្រធានសំណាក់ក្រុមប្រឹក្សាអន្តរជាតិនៅក្នុងប្រទេសកម្ពុជាដែលមានលោកសុនសេនជាប្រធានសំណាក់ក្រុមប្រឹក្សាអន្តរជាតិនៅក្នុងប្រទេសកម្ពុជាដែលមានលោកសុនសេនជាប្រធានសំណាក់ក្រុ
Sir, you told us this morning that you were detained at Phnom Krol. Can you tell us a bit more where that location, where on Phnom Krol the building was that you were detained? Was it at the bottom, at the top? Can you describe a bit the location?
Hai lok weng nung ke khum khluon nei na ke khum khluon bontuk khang krom ru ko ke khum khluon no bontuk khang leu
ba roch khom ban chomriep prak mynh puok khom nung ke khum khang krom ba ke khum nou Phnom Krol nung munti from Krol to Teath Mon.
Thank you. Perhaps I wasn't clear. What I'm asking is the building that you were detained in, was that at the bottom of the hill, at the top of Phnom Krol? Where was it?
Thank you. I'm asking is the building that you were detained in, was that at the bottom of the hill, at the top of
Phnom Krol? Trong mon ti te hien nau lau te hien srok nau lau
nang tam sir thank you sir do you have any knowledge of killing fields of places where corpses of people killed during the DK regime. Do you have any knowledge of such locations in your district, in that district,
near Phnom Krol?
Sir,
I
don't know what to do. I don't know what to do.
Can you tell us what you know, what you learned?
Som lok chomriep chun talaka bantich mo lok dang avai khlas dae.
Ba doy khom chomriep chun chang hai. Tam khom dang nung dang na panang. Và thà khơi cái sầm lấp ấy co lưỡi của miên đau ấy nó gọt khơi đã
okay thank you well do you know if there were pits discovered after the regime
ta lục đằng thà kề miên rộp khơi nhờ đau gọt khmoi nâu còn lại nà đá còi bị rộp nụ mò
บ่าลือเด้อ
I want to talk to you a bit about
a man you've mentioned this morning,
forgive my pronunciation if it's not correct. Pankon.
Pankon.
Did you know him, Pankon?
Tao Luk Skol Chu.
You said he was the assembly representative, is that correct?
Kampun. Sorry,
I take that back. I'm confusing two names here. I want to talk about Pankon. Can you tell us who was Pankon?
Pankon, ta Pankon chi neak na luk skol te.
Ma Pankon no do ot skol te, mien chmua te. Pankon. Mien chmua te.
Pankon.
Ba ba Pankon nung skol.
I'm not asking you now about Kampon.
I'm
asking you about Pankon.
Pankon.
Do you know him?
Pankon.
Okay. Let me, I'd like to show you something, and it's E3/1645. Mr. President, if I could have the witness be given my version of this.
So he could look on with me.
Thank you. And this is a list with a date on it of 23 November 1977, and it's a list of the names of prisoners who entered S-21 on that date. I'm not going to go through all of the names on there, but you'll see it's beginning at number
97,
there appear to be, particularly at number 106.
106
up through 143, there are indications that these are people from Sector 105. And I want you to direct your attention to number 128. So that's the second column. It indicates a Phan Kong with the alias or the
Chun. 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 Chun.
Chun. Who is listed as 35-year-old male and says state commerce member, Sector 105. Do you know this person?
Perhaps. The
Let me just repeat it. I'll read it for you, sir. Number 128, it indicates, I have my colleague read it, so it's more clear.
Lake Rieng Ti 128, in the Kalaun Ti 2,
Lake Rieng Ti 128, Phan Phan Khun, Hau Chun, Ayu 35 chnam, Phet Pro,
Sir, do you recall this person?
Look, say, look, call Munumanity.
But more pancorn, no, I'm scolding.
Thank you. Can you tell us what was his position in the DK regime? What positions did he hold?
can mục đầm nai như vậy đấy nó không được bóp Campuchia bởi chế thập tay
mà chúng mà phan khôn nóng nâu bóp nóng quật nâu bên này chứ cầm được trên được ấy được có nặt được ấy chè chun chè chuôn cả lắm
Thank you. And this Phan Khun, did he have any family relation? Was he related in any way to Ham Phun?
The man earlier that you talked about
who was involved in the incident in Phnom Penh, where Hom was killed in exchange fire,
was Phan Khun,
the man on the list that you just saw,
Phan
related
Khun
to
Kham Phun?
Mà tâm ngài chmua phan khôn nâng cứ chìa phôn thay bỏ ta hòm đó về nó bàn miên bình hà đó tâm khuyên bình nịch tớ đừng nâng bởi hà chìa kháng xe ta hòm nâng nâng khân oi khâm phun nâng có chắp tiền cái xe ta phan khôn liền ọt ra
Sir, had you heard or were you aware at the time Phan Khun had been arrested?
Phan Khun ni trob ban ke chap khluon dai te.
Ma pel thmai thmai ni ot dang na ba. Kroy mo rol dol chnam rom doh na ban dang.
And do you know anything? Do you know anything about what happened to Phan Khun's family?
Ta lục đăng tham yên away cát lang đòn cua sa Phan Khun nè đái.
Bất sân na chía
Phan Khun nè miền bờ bốn côn ở bụng mà đái. Ta miền away cát lang từ đó xem chiếc cầm cua sa ở bọc quần. Nó bị kẹp chặt luôn quần.
Và khem đăng bài nhàn nằng. Đó cái bắt phan khôn nó có bắt tiền côn tiền bộ phân là hốt đó là lâu bắt là hốt lên lưng lầm lưng ấy tiếng ơ và
You also told us that your boss Rao was arrested.
Có bạn chụp được chun tà la ca mê rô bò lô chmô ra nế cà trâu bàn chạp luôn ta miên ở vấy cà là tụt đò chmô ra nế
Bà ra nâng chìa khám mùi rồi bò ta khám phùn. Đó là chẳng ta khám phùn ngọp tớ. Có bọn bọn khẳng ta hôm nâng có chắp cái xe ta khám phùn nâng chìa ra nâng tớ tiếng ọt đà mà bụt nhưng đà. Và
What about Ra's family? I don't know if he had any, but did he have a wife, children, siblings?
Ra miền do you know what happened to him? Miền côn, miền bong ôn bằng cát ấy đại thế, hãy bớt sân chỉ miến, lục đăng thạch tao miền ở bãi cát làng tốt đòl xa mạ trực sạch nhiệt ở bọc con hộ đại thế.
Bà đăng bong ôn gọt bong ôn cho mùa ra nắng, cái bắt luôn hốt đó là lâu tiếng ọt đại.
Thank you. Mr. President, I'd like to have the witness shown E3156 in the Khmer. I have it here. Mr. Witness, I'm going to read from the document. You can follow along.
It
indicates
on
the top left that it's a telegram and the number is 54. Here after that, radio band 290. It's addressed to respected brother.
Written
next to that is Uncle Nguyen. It then talks in the first paragraph saying that situation of the outside enemy, UN spies entered the division location. I won't read the rest of that. The second paragraph, based on analysis, the division
plan.
Oui, Monsieur le Président, avant que Monsieur le Procureur lise ce télégramme au témoin, peut-être plus de questions d'introduction pour savoir quel est le lien entre ce témoin et le document et quel est le lien que fait Monsieur le Procureur et en quoi le témoin serait susceptible de commenter ce document. Les étapes préliminaires n'ont pas été faites que l'objet à ce qu'on lise le document au témoin sans ces déclarations, sans ces questions.
Your Honor, I'm about to get to the connection to the witness because, in fact, this does concern the gentleman who I just was talking about, who's also mentioned in this telegram, known by the moniker Chun. So I can satisfy counsel if I can read. I hope to satisfy her if I read a bit more.
If I may, Mr. President,
I didn't object because I know the chamber doesn't require any nexus between the witness and the document. However, just saying that Chun is in the document obviously is not any reason to connect this document. However, I know you will allow it.
We
just had the defense make an application to admit documents by an unknown author. Going on to the third paragraph, excuse me, the issue of the situation inside the party. Comrades, I'll have my colleague pronounce the name. Comrade Sot, chairman of the repair factory, has committed immoral acts with a woman. Now the arrests have been made. Both the man and the woman have been arrested. The comrade was previously implicated in the confession of the traitor
Ajun.
At that time, the sector monitored his activities. So, sir, do you know, have you ever heard of the comrade Sot, the chairman of the repair
factory?
Well, sir, the letter indicates it's signed by Sarun. Is that the name of the man that you said replaced home as district secretary? And what happened to Sot? Do you know, did he survive the regime?
ថាគាត់នឹងរស់រៀនមានជីវិតពីរបបនោះដែរឬក៏អត់ទេលោកដឹងថាមានអ្វីកើតឡើងទៅដល់ឈ្មោះសុតនេះដែរទេកាលនោះសុតនោះក៏នៅមកដុំភ្នំក្រលនឹងដែរនៅកន្លែងក្រាស់ឡានផងនៅតែណាទៅណីទេការងារគាត់នឹងមិនច្បាស់លាស់ទេមិនបានអ្នកសួរការដឹងការងារក៏ឯធំដុំទេគាត់តែដឹងថាមានឈ្មោះសុតមាន
Okay, so again, if you don't know, that's fine, but do you know whether or not this Sot was arrested or whether or not he survived the regime? This telegram is dated April 1978. Do you know?
គឺ 23 មេសា ឆ្នាំ 78 លោកដឹងទេសុតនេះ មាន អ្វី កើត ឡើង ចំពោះ សុតនេះ
បាទ ដោយ ខ្ញុំ បាន ជម្រាប អញ្ចឹង ហើយ បញ្ហា គេ នៅ ថ្នាក់ លើ នោះ មិន អាច ដឹង បាន ទេ បាទ
Okay sir, I'm not asking you what happened at the upper level. Have you ever seen Sot? មាន អ្វី កើត ឡើង ដល់ ថ្នាក់ លើ នោះ ទេ Since 1978
ចាប់ពីឆ្នាំ 1978 តទៅមកតើលោកធ្លាប់បានជួបឈ្មោះសុតនេះទៀតទេ
មកដោយខ្ញុំជម្រាបកាលដើមមកថាមានឈ្មោះសុតហ្នឹងជាមួយឈ្មោះកម្មហ្នឹងទៅចាប់បោះខ្ញុំមិនដឹងតែប៉ុណ្ណឹងរហូតបាត់ឈ្មោះរហូតទៅ
Okay, thank you. Just a few clarifications. When you were a messenger, were you armed?
No, pe dai lok phoe che ne risa lok mien kan kam phleung te ke mien aoy awut lok prau prah te
ba ka nau thoe ne risa ke ne ke aoy kan ba
Did you have any other duties, any combat duties besides being a messenger? Lok mien
phirakech awai krau pi nirasa ni dai te mien chol ruom prayut ay nou samorphum na ay dai te
Ba khem ot mien prayut nou na te mien ta ka pia ke dol ke chap khluon nou ko chop kan kam phleung tang phu nang rohot te rohot dol ke yo to dak karathan nang rohot da phu nang dol rom doh chet 9 nang
Thank you. Now, during the regime, that is from April 1975 to the end of
1978,
were there any Vietnamese in your district? In the district? I was in the district. I was in the district. Vai trò là mong Phải bật mục là mong
Do you know if any Vietnamese refugees passing through your district were, to your knowledge, were captured?
Đăng tha former soldiers of the two anti-communist regime
ជនជាតិចូលមកចូលក្នុងស្រុករបស់លោកទេដូចជាវៀតណាមកាត់ចិនដូចជាជនជាតិម៉ុងតេណាឬក៏ទាហានយួនចុះចាញ់អីចឹងចូលមកក្នុងស្រុករបស់លោកមានទេមកកាលរបបពលពតហ្នឹងដូចអត់មានជនជាតិវៀតណាមជនជាតិអីមកចូលទេកាលរបបហ្នឹង
Okay, thank you. How about in your area, did some of your fellow neighbors have relatives who had been Lon Nol soldiers? Why was he arrested and taken away to be killed, if you know? When you were working as a messenger and armed by them, did they give you any instructions? Did you receive any trainings about how to treat enemies?
Now, you indicated that you didn't have a lawyer, and I presume you didn't have a trial. Did you ever see or hear any judicial proceedings during the regime where people were given a trial, or told they had rights?
You could break now, Mr. President, if you'd like.
Look, Tien, some of them are by the night wrong.
Look, the Capi will lead them down here by Mantit, and on car to in Dow Satay Rumni, on your method of Majet Tat, Satay Rumni, mean pay will lead that I need the non car for dolls that they come, like a pumuk, on to Nunjum Brea.
Your Honor, I had one more question. I was going to turn it over to the civil parties. Did you lose any relatives during the regime, you yourself?
Thank
you, Your Honor. I turn it over to the civil
parties. Thank you, sir.
លោកប្រធានអនុញ្ញាតសូមអរគុណលោកប្រធានលោកប្រសិទ្ធចៅក្រមទីគោរពនិងអង្គសវនការទាំងអស់ទីក្រុមបាទហុងកំសួនជាមេធាវីតំណាងដើមនឹងរដ្ឋវិនីសូមសួរបន្ថែមបញ្ជាវិញទេដល់លោកសាក់សីតេតតងទៅជាមួយនឹងមន្ទីរសន្តិសុខភ្នំក្រោលទៅប៉ុណ្ណោះលោកប្រធានបានសួរលោកច្រើនដែរអំពីការងាររបស់លោកមុនពេលដែលលោកមកធ្វើជាមុនពេលដែលគេចាប់ខ្លួនលោកមកដាក់ក្នុងមន្ទីរសន្តិសុខភ្នំក្រោលនេះខ្ញុំសួរលោកបន្តិចថាតើ
នៅក្នុងស្រុកដែលលោករស់នៅក្នុងសម័យកម្ពុជាប្រជាធិបតេយ្យហ្នឹងលោករស់នៅតែស្រុកកោះញែកតែមួយឬក៏មានបដូរស្រុកផ្សេងទៀតទេ
Bà khi ông rùa nâu thì sọc rồi mùa nó, mình đồ sọc tàu nà mò nà.
Nó không xa mai khá mai khá hôm nâng, sọc có nhé, mình đã chú mùa chỉ lê chì à xó ếp xên vì chú mùa có nhé đại tế.
Bà khá nó đừng, đừng khá đá về đại chú mùa nó, bà đừng chỉ lê chì nây sợi về đại sọc, có nhé nó về sọc.
រូមួយអញ្ចឹងបាទសូមអរគុណឥឡូវចូលដល់នៅក្នុងមន្ទីរសន្តិសុខតើមន្ទីរសន្តិសុខភ្នំក្រោលមានឈ្មោះហៅផ្សេងក្រៅពីឈ្មោះភ្នំក្រោលនឹងទៀតទេតើទេមកចង់ឆ្លើយតបសូមចេញលោកមេធាវីវិទ្យាកុពេ
Might be a detail, but I don't think.
Chúng nói ai lùm ắt bận tay hay. Bận tay. Say ban gì hay thà. Cần lại để cái khung plot của mình mình chưa cục thế, mình chưa mình ti son sọc thế, chưa mình ti robot làm bon rồi pram.
ឬជាណេះសូមឲ្យសួរបញ្ជាក់ឲ្យច្បាស់មើលថាកន្លែងហ្នឹងឲ្យវាជាគុកឬក៏វាជាមន្ទីរសន្តិសុខឬក៏វាជាវាជាមន្ទីររបស់តំបន់105ខ្ញុំបាទសូមឆ្លើយលោកធានខ្ញុំមិនបាននិយាយពីពាក្យថាគុកទេបាទមិញខ្ញុំសួរទៅសាក់សីដោយសារនៅក្នុងឯកសារបានសរសេរអំពីមន្ទីរសន្តិសុខភ្នំក្រោលអញ្ចឹងខ្ញុំបាទក៏សួរទៅតាម
អសដែលមានសេសេនៅក្នុងឯកសារនេះសម្បត្តិសូមបន្តការសាក់សួរទៀតបាទបាទអញ្ជើញសួរទៀតចុះហើយមេធាវីកុំរំខានទេចាំដល់ពេលលោកទៅលោករំចាំសួរលំអិតទៅបើសិនជាសាក់សេសឆ្លៃមិនច្បាស់នោះវាបានផលប្រយោជន៍ពេញចម្រឹងទៅលើមេធាវីហើយចឹងខ្ញុំសូមសួរបន្តទៅទៀតថានៅក្នុងមន្ទីរសន្តិសុខភ្នំក្រោលអគារដែលគេឃុំឃាំងលោក
នឹងប្រជាពលរដ្ឋផ្សេងទៀតនឹងមានអាគារផ្សេងពីនឹងទៀតដែរទេបាទកន្លែងឃុំឃាំងនឹងជាមន្ទីររបស់តំបន់របស់ឃុំឃាំងខ្ញុំឃុំឃាំងរបស់ខ្ញុំបាទសូមអរគុណខ្ញុំសួរថាក្រៅអំពីអាគារដែលឃុំឃាំងលោកនឹង
នៅក្នុងមន្ទីរហ្នឹងមានអាគារផ្សេងទៀតដែលឃុំឃាំងផ្សេងទៀតដែរទេបាទអត់ឃើញទេរឿងកន្លែងឃុំឃាំងផ្សេងៗដូចជាមានកន្លែងដឹងថាកន្លែងសន្តិសុខគេប៉ុណ្ណឹងបាទសូមអរគុណខ្ញុំសួរបន្តតទៅជាមួយនឹងការចាប់លោកប្រពន្ធលោកនិងប្រជាពលរដ្ឋទាំងអស់លោកមានប្រសាសន៍ហើយថាប្រហែលជា 88 នាក់
តើ88នាក់ហ្នឹងមនុស្សប្រុសមនុស្សស្រីនិងកូនក្មេងគេដាក់រួមគ្នាឬក៏មានការបែងចែកស្រីផ្សេងប្រុសផ្សេងក្មេងផ្សេងដែរបាទគេកាលគេចងហ្នឹងគេចងស្រីមកខាងទៅអញ្ចឹងចងប្រុសប្រុសហ្នឹងមកខាងមកអញ្ចឹងទៅក្មេងក្មេងទូចទូចហ្នឹងគេអត់ចង
បាទខ្ញុំមិនច្រឡំទេមានន័យថាបន្ទាគារមួយហ្នឹងដាក់ទាំងស្រីទាំងប្រុសគ្រាន់តែថាចងដាក់មកជាហៀងស្រីជាហៀងប្រុសតែអញ្ចឹងមែនទេបាទបញ្ហានឹងអញ្ចឹងមែនបាទសូមអរគុណខ្ញុំសួរអំពីស្ថានភាពនៃការរស់នៅឬក៏ការឃុំឃាំងលោកនៅក្នុងអាគារនោះ ពីព្រឹកមិញលោកបានជម្រាបជូនអង្គសាវនាការអំពីរបបហូប លោក
mình bật xa bằng tình mà thật ta rồi bọp hộp nâng rồi có bài rồi có mà hộp nâng cái ai mùi ngay nâng chùm nọc bởi dư dân kích thì chan rồi có chìa về với ban phẩm màn đấy nông mình nè
bà đôi trong chùm riệp được mình thả bài nâng vì ai mình nè mà chan chỉ cờ bà nâng sụp đã lò lập bầu rồi bà nâng
lúc ban tự tu rồi bỏ hộp phẩm màn bê lúc nông mặt ngày hay cái chai ai bê là khá
chuẩn cá về ai hộp bê là ngày trăng nghe ọt đâu chuẩn cá ai hộp là nghe bật ọt đâu
dạ xong bà con
bà con là nít đọc bê xong trọng tâm rã hay ông bê bà ca bà tâm rã chào bà bê nít tôi tới hốt đó mong mùi cả lạ bà xin lít thông anh chơi nhiều và to cái chấm đá ca sạm đá ca to để tiết hay mình treo cho ba đá ca rồi rồi bắt đầu lại chấm đá được tụt rung chạm thì sạ sấy đào sạ sấy đúng đi nên không lòng về chấm đá ngay trắng nhưng ở trên con một căn lại bắt đầu sấy cam thằng nông tụt sạm đá ca đi nơi về liềm mong mùi cả là rồi xiêm hay có bà nó rẽm chỉ công khang nông luôn luôn khi sầm phong tập lập được căn một tụt rung chạm khang cầm sa sạm đá ca đi hay là một có bà nông luôn có lo cho rôm sạm đá ca nơi không một tụt sạm đá ca đi với nơi rồi xiêm đi hay ban môn mong mùi cả là
xong rồi cho. Xong trên cao chờ.